The Catholic Church has had scammers for 2,000 years.
You have the audacity to call me the communist.
We hate to break it to you, but your mother's been taken over by a cult.
He can be cunning, charming, angry.
It was very clear that Ryan was not actually a priest.
They can say all they want that I'm not a priest.
He's not been ordained.
I'm 10 times more of a priest than I'll ever think of being.
He had her sign on as a nun and sign over everything she had.
People described being really impressed by him. They felt that God was in the room while he was up at the pulpit preaching.
He was moving around every few years. It would depend on how much trouble he was getting into.
Father Ryan essentially wants your property.
Well, he hopes to get a good outcome.
Father Ryan did this for about 30 years, traveling the Midwest, opening different churches.
Did our Lord give all the apostles a piece of paper with a raised seal? I don't think so.
My name is Alex Schumann. I'm a journalist who spent a couple of years investigating Father Ryan. I came across an article from a woman saying, "I lost my mother to a cult." One of the first things I found when I Googled his name was this photo of him in the 70s with this huge, almost porn star mustache. And I thought, how is this guy a priest? He's not a priest at all.
How many abbeys did you have?
We only had one abbey. But we moved. You want the rundown?
Yeah.
We started out in Viroqua, Wisconsin. From there, we went to Eastman, Wisconsin. From there, Independence, Iowa, to North Dakota, Galesburg, Illinois, Buchanan, Iowa, to Missouri.
Father Ryan did this for about 30 years, traveling the Midwest, opening different churches. It's not like he shows up in town and hides himself. He always just shows up and lets everybody know he's there and attracts so much attention that I think a lot of people think you would never do that if you were not a real priest. He showed up at the town council meetings, he meets with mayors, he goes to the local newspapers, he likes attention. People described being really impressed by him. They felt that God was in the room while he was up at the pulpit preaching.
I want to just take a minute here.
Absolutely.
Because my priesthood has been questioned.
The impression that I got from people who had interacted with him was that he was this incredibly cunning, charismatic guy that was very impressive. That's why people were falling for him. And then when I met him, that wasn't the impression that I really got.
I have my parchment from Rome.
These are the different papers that he showed me to prove that he was a priest. This ended up being something that you can just buy and order online from a gift shop that's right outside the Vatican.
My name's Jonathan Brady. I am the biological son of Ryan Scott. The simple fact that I exist, that I live and breathe, wipes out any legitimate claims to ordination that he has in the eyes of the church. So what do you do? If you're a con man trying to edit and create a story, you get rid of the evidence. And I'm the evidence. I was adopted at right around the age of 8. As far as the rest of the world knew, I didn't exist.
I was a nun in Father Ryan's church. When I met him, everything seemed okay at first, but then little things add up.
Once he's burnt out in an area, he moves on, sets up somewhere else, finds a new set of victims to pull in.
He was able to get money from a lot of the elderly group of women that became devout followers of his.
He tricked people out of several million. He would have appeals to fix his abbey's roof, the heating, equipment appeals.
And he would go and buy these valuable Catholic artifacts. Like, how many statues of Jesus do you need?
He started dealing in religious artifacts, rare religious manuscripts, religious items, and we've been able to track all those on various websites that he's been selling on.
There seemed to be a lot of stuff on eBay.
Inevitably, the police or the local Catholic diocese would start alerting people, and he would get run out of town. One of his abbeys was in Galesburg, Illinois, and this is probably the time period when Ryan would have been the most successful. That's also where he had the llama farm. And they are not just regular llamas. They are very expensive, rare llamas that end up fetching quite a bit of money. So some of the money that he was getting from donations, he was also using to buy llamas that cost like $3,000 to $6,000. Father Ryan also opened a business while he had these llamas. There was a petting zoo where he was also selling the fleece under the brand name Monastic Fleece. So people would be under the understanding that they were supporting this priest and a group of nuns, and it gives you the idea that you're doing something good, when in reality, Ryan is not a priest at all.
Galesburg is where we caught him, and that's when the Attorney General's office really got involved with it. He jumped state, went over to Missouri when he was told not to.
He just leaves everything behind, and they leave overnight, pack up what they can, and part of what they leave are 19 llamas. It's just so weird.
I ran up against his temper one day. I had asked to leave at that point, and he would not let me. And then 2 days later, he decided it was his choice to let me go. One of the families that had fallen out with him had given me his actual name. And then when I ran it through a computer, it had pulled up things like his arrest record. Well, I'm realizing he's not a priest.
She starts to uncover who Ryan really is. And she's mad.
I did tell people, but a lot of them didn't believe in me.
His biggest money makers were Rosanna and Sheila.
Ryan was in his 50s when Rosanna allegedly adopted him.
She had entered the following as a nun. She was a highly religious woman looking for the peace that usually comes from somebody joining the church and living that kind of lifestyle. This is the last bit of my life. I'm dedicating it to God and my faith.
He claimed that she adopted him as an adult, so the abbey would inherit some of her land and money.
I cannot see any reason why somebody at that age would adopt a grown man. To me, that just cemented his grips on any inheritance or any financials that he could pull out of her other than what he had already done. The level of mental control you would have to have over somebody to get them to go along with that is beyond my understanding. Sheila was another victim of Ryan Scott.
He had her sign on as a nun and sign over everything she had.
He ended up convincing her to give him more than $100,000. But to her, it was a loan, and to him, it was a donation. So when she and her family tried to come and get it back, Ryan refused and said the money was gone.
When you're talking to Rosanna's kids or Sheila's children, you're dealing with people that were trying to get their parents out of a situation and they couldn't reach them. That's how far his brainwashing of these folks went.
Not only does he take people's money, he takes their connection to God.
People think that they've been absolved of all their sins in confession, they're married in the eyes of God, and come to find out that, well, hey, guess what? You gotta go do it again.
All of that was void because he was not actually a Catholic priest. There's a much deeper crime happening in terms of people's spirituality. Ryan was in jail for a short period of time in Missouri. But because a prosecutor is scared to say, your version of Catholicism is not true, or you are not truly a Catholic priest, prevented him from ever facing real consequences.
Anytime you strap the word church to law enforcement, they back off. It's like a magic wand. We're not going to touch it with a 20,000-foot pole. The American justice system has shown me that there is no such thing as justice in this country.
from the evidence I've seen, we have not seen the end of him pretending to be a priest.
Every few years, I'm either contacted by a victim, a reporter, law enforcement.
I recently caught him attaching an address to accept donations to a church in Portugal. So he's gone from targeting people just in the Midwest to communicating and portraying himself as a priest worldwide.
There's still people getting hurt. He's always going to face justice somewhere. If not in this life, well, there's the afterlife.